I'm Jennifer D. Scroggins.
And I'm Stevie Regven. This is my monkey, Jackson.
And we're here to talk to you about what's going on with my writing this month. It's July, I think it's July 2nd. And I just recently put out a new book. It's called Paying the Piper. And it's out on ebook and in print, as you can see. And my son, who's now 16, much, much bigger than he was in this picture, is the cover. He is also the young man who wrote the music and played the guitar for the soundtrack of the book trailer for Face in the Rearview Mirror. The boy's never had a formal guitar lesson in his life. He's all self-taught. Taught himself how to read music. He mostly plays by ear, but he wrote that song and all of it by himself. He also put together the pictures that my friends from Texas sent us for making that book trailer. Only a couple of the pictures that are in that whole little thing for Face in the Rearview Mirror didn't come from them. The picture of the two kids, one of them's her and one of them's her brother Stubby, that was shot here in Portland. And that was one of those moments, you know, it was kind of interesting seeing those two repeating a, you know, walk that was taken, you know, 30-something years earlier. But anyway, my son Chance let me use his picture, not without sizable cost, let me tell you. I had to take down one of our favorite videos ever from YouTube because of it. My son is quite the mimic, and he wanted to go see a friend of his in a ballet downtown Portland, and between the cost of the train ride down there and the ticket, he needed $40. So, actually it was her idea, we came up with the idea that he would do one of his best routines for us for $40. He wants to be a little rock star actor himself when he gets older. So we paid him $40 to do his best imitation of a certain young man who happens to be her favorite young man. And so with much, much cajoling and begging, and it went from 20 to 40 before it was all said and done. My son did his best Jackson Rathbone circa Disney 411 days imitation, and I enjoyed that video much, and it stayed up on YouTube for, a month and a half almost?
Yeah.
And we got quite a few giggles over it before he, made me take it down. He was always convinced. He's like, that boy's gonna hunt you down and kill you or kick my butt. So... yeah, he was like so eager to have that one down, and he was just looking for the right time to force it. So yeah, it's gone, and I got my cover. Anyway, so Paying the Piper is available. The book trailer for Face in the Rearview Mirror is up on YouTube. It's also on the Facebook page, floating around all over the place. I tweet it out about once a day. Friends retweet it. It's on her Facebook page. I'm very proud of it. I'm very proud of the fact my son wrote that song, played the guitar on his, you know, secondhand Washburn sitting at my kitchen table. We recorded it on my iPhone, and you can hear the creaking in my chair as I have to move forward to keep it from falling over. And it was just one of those things that it was done on a nothing budget and with, you know, friends and family participating and all amateur, all indie artists who have nobody backing them. No Kickstarter, no nothing. Just the bare bones, bare minimum. We're out here doing this on our own. let's see. What we wanted to ask about, besides, not the contest, it was a vote we had up on the Facebook page. We wanted people to tell us which book they wanted to have made into a trailer next. And everybody, you know, had a little opportunity to vote and tell us what they thought. And, of course, everybody would pick the one that we don't have the most pictures of yet. and that would be Paying the Piper. So that will be our next book trailer, and my son's already working on a song for that one. So as soon as he gets back from his little vacation at the coast with his friends, hopefully we'll get something going on. My friends are already shooting pictures for it, and, you know, I'm putting together, you know, folder on it, and hopefully next week, two, three weeks, we'll have something up for that one. One of the things I'm curious about is this one, Drifts. I have people here where I live in Portland who have found out I'm an author. I don't know how. I don't talk about it much, which I've been told is a problem. I know I need to talk about it more in public and stuff like that. It's not a dirty little secret. It's just not something. I'm not a very demonstrative person in public. And the few people who have found out have told other people, and they've told other people. My boss that I work for talks quite a bit, I've come to find out. And so I've had people come to my door wanting to buy my books, and that's a bit shocking. Well, one of the first ones I hand off to them, or, you know, trade to them or whatever, is this one, because it's cheap. You know, I'm not an expensive person. I'm not a big fancy person. And for some reason, this book drives people out of their rabbit-ass minds. Pardon my language. And I've been grabbed. People, like, hug me, and they're like, I love your book. I think you've got to write a sequel. There are no halfway reactions over this book. And I don't... Why? Why? What is the deal with this book? I wrote it on a lark. Okay? I heard a young man tell a story. I had one of them motherly, because I am the mother of 20-something and of an older teen. I had one of them motherly, what the hell were you thinking, reactions. If it had been my kid, there would have been a boot so far up his ass, he would have been, I just keep cussing. He would have been tasting boot leather for a while. And I also had one of them cop reactions, like, oh, this could have all gone so bad wrong, so bad wrong. I'm an ex-cop. I investigated cases where it did go very, very, very wrong. Very bad. And, you know, a lot like in the book, wrong. Exactly. Pretty little boys don't always have pretty little things happen to them. So, it just, I don't get the whole positive reaction people have to the story. Maybe because I am familiar with the original version that I wrote, and it was a lot darker, folks, and so maybe that's where my stumbling block is with this, is I remember the original version of it, and people want a sequel to it, and it's like, okay, well, I have to have the characters talk to me again. I don't just force stories. If something speaks to me, I write it. It has to speak to me. I have two or three stories right now that I started, and the character stopped talking to me. And my muse is a flighty little fella. And when he stops and, you know, goes on a runner on me, I quit writing. Because you don't force writing. It either comes tearing out of you, burning out of you, or you don't write. You just take a little vacation. That's what I've tried telling her. And she gets rather annoyed with me. And she brings in the enforcer and says, why aren't you writing? It's because I'm not feeling it right now. I have to feel it. And when I do feel it, I go on these intensive writing jags where I don't sleep. And I've been writing some. You can tell by the dark circles under my eyes. But it's different stuff. So, this one, though, when it does start speaking to me again, if it does, there'll be a sequel. Maybe. But, I just don't understand. I mean, I've had stories where I've read them and I'm like, wow, that would make a great, you know, I'd like to see more of these characters. But this one, I'm kind of like, I thought I'd left it in a good place. But if you disagree, look me up on Twitter and Facebook and let me know why. My Twitter handle is CalamityGen1. My Facebook for my writing is Jennifer D. Scroggins. It's an author's page. And shoot me a note and tell me what your opinion on this is. Because I guess because I said I'm familiar with the very dark version I wrote of it. So, you know, and no, I did not save the very dark version. I got rid of it. It is one of them things that's like, you don't want that laying around. I have the three books out right now. There are others sitting on my desktop right now that are pretty much completed, but I'm not going to get into a big rush to publish because, you know, when you have a lot of stuff out there, people are like, oh, they're just like throwing stuff out there. No, I wrote and wrote and wrote and wrote and wrote, but it's, to me, it's not junk. It's stuff I take very seriously and I want to do it right and things like that. So I'm going to keep writing and keep stacking stuff up, and that way if I'm not here in the future, she'll take it and publish it. You know, it'll be hers because she's a little slave driver, and I think she'll be the one to do something with it. Won't you, Stevie Ray?
Yep.
There you go. And she's got talent in her own right. I mean, she does her own writing and stuff too, so she'll keep me motivated as long as I can. It takes me a little while to get the eyes to focus in the morning too, so we'll see. But I'm working on things as best I can, but feedback would be nice. You know, if you've read my stuff, do me a favor and review. If you like it, cool. If you didn't like it, tell me why not. If you got any suggestions, I'm a big girl. Let me hear them. I've got a couple editors now that are helping me out. I gave them some props on this last book, and man, I appreciate them because, you know, when your eyes can't tell the difference between a comma and a period anymore, or the single versus the double quotations, it helps to have help. So, to, you know, Melissa and Christy, thank you. And I now have an artist that's helping me with my advertising, Melissa Condor at Hobie 1971 Art. She's got my author's page flyer thingy done, and I'm gonna hopefully get it printed pretty soon. So I've got to do a book signing. That's like going out and talking and interacting with people. That's going to be all kinds of interesting. So I have a feeling I'm gonna try to get her to do it. If you want a signed copy of any of my books, let me know. What I do is I'll sign it, send it to you, and we'll work out the payment somehow. I'm willing to do that. I do shipping and all kinds of stuff. I've got an order of books coming here July 12th, so we'll get it figured out. Anyway, thank you much. What do you say?
Bye.